Hey folks, Squint here, recording another reaction video where I watch content put out by more experienced members of the fighting game community and see if I can pick up any tips, tricks, and lessons for myself and give my thoughts on them in real time. So without any further ado, this is Seijam Talks, How to Learn and Improving as a Player. And I'm going to give this a watch and see what he's got to say. Take it away, Seijam.
The thing about improving as a player, or any fighting game in general, this is just like a general topic. To improve at a skill, whether it's commentary or playing fighting games or learning how to play piano or learning how to beatbox or learning how to cook, is that you have to realize a couple of important things when you want to improve. One, you have to realize first and foremost that you suck. Everybody sucks at whatever skill they're trying to learn. There is always room to improve, and if you...
I can't argue with that there, especially if y'all saw my SNK stream. I was pretty unprepared for even the AI in King of Fighters 98.
If you ever forget that, or if you ever stop thinking that you have places to go up, you won't improve, right? The minute you think you're the best you'll ever be is when you cap out and there's no room to realize that you have the ability to improve, right? There's always more that you could learn or improve or get better at. You know what I mean? So realizing first that you suck, not just you, everybody sucks. Super strong players. You'll turn into a stream. This guy will be Grandmaster Ultra 420 Blaze It rank, and he'll be like, man, I missed that anti-air there. I didn't get the meaty timing right. I missed my combo. I suck. Man, I fucking suck. And it's like, this dude is like fourth ranked on the leaderboards. He beats all these good players. He places in CPT events, and he's like, I suck, right? There's always room to improve, right? The second thing is you have to remember that when you're learning any skill, it's not about immediate results, and it's not about winning or losing. It's not about, you know, how you're doing on that day. It's about building skills. So when you're, let's say you're a fighting game.
Okay, I don't know what he's about to say, but when I stream the fighting games, especially in these like early familiarization streams, I get caught up in wanting to win. Even though it's against the AI, I still want to win because winning feels like progress, but I don't think that's necessarily the case. Winning against the AI doesn't really mean you've improved, especially if you haven't learned anything new or you don't know why something worked or why other things didn't work. So it's easy to get caught up in the moment, but I try to back off of that when I can catch myself. And I'll do things that for the match are maybe suboptimal, but things I want to try out or... like especially if the AI is spamming a move, I want to see if I can figure out a way to make that move less effective, which I know I've been advised by people watching my stream that that's what like the training mode is for with the dummies. But anyway, I'll let Seijam continue.
Player, and this is what you have as a player, right? These are your skills. What you need to do every day is when you're playing, don't play to win, right? Don't play around at all. Instead, play over on and thank Ryu. Ryu for the Twitch Prime, thanks very much. So you have this set of skills and you're playing, right? While you're playing, all you're looking to do is improve, right? Don't play to win, don't play to beat your friends or whatever, right? You're looking to improve. And improving will make you win more, right? So in general, you shouldn't play to win. You have this bundle of skills, right? And let's say you're playing and what you realize is, you know what I'm really bad at? I'm really bad at anti-airing. So you're trying to build your skills by like, all right, now I'm gonna practice anti-airing. So I'm gonna bring that into my thing. You know what I realized? As a habit, I have a really nasty habit of always teching on defense. So I need to remove that from my bundle of skills, right? And it's always improving, 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 right? So grinding and trying to.
Okay, I have some idea of what teching means. What I'm not clear on right now is why removing teching from your repertoire would be an improvement unless it's to set up situations where you miss the tech or whatever, but continue.
You fix the issues you have and playing to improve instead of playing to win. Because if you play a match, right, and you're like, I never anti-air. My anti-airs suck. And you play against a guy and you're like, no matter what happens in this match, I'm going to anti-air. And he jumps at you and you miss your anti-air. But then you mash jab and you get a hit and you kill him anyway and you win the match, right? You won the game, but you didn't improve. You know what I mean? So that's why focusing on improvement is more important than focusing on winning, Because winning isn't a sign of improving. Everybody can win, you know, matches here and there. But if you want to consistently win, if you want to consistently become a better player, you need to focus on improving instead of focusing on playing. And it's like that for any skill, right? It's like that.
Yeah, I think I'm still light years away from playing to win, really.
Like, and there are going to come times where you struggle to learn something, but learning how to do that is more important than just giving up and like trying to skirt around it by using your other skill sets. Like, maybe you want to learn how to play piano. When you first start, you're not going to be able to get your hands to work at the same time. You're barely going to be able to play chords. You're barely going to, you can't remember where the notes are on them. Where the hell is middle C? Is it this C or is it that C? Is that a C or is that a G? I don't know. There's going to be stuff like that when you're learning. You won't know how to sight read. You'll be like memorizing songs and trying to play them back. You're going to struggle, right? But then you'll learn how to use both hands. You'll learn how to sight read. You'll learn where all the keys are on the keyboard. You'll learn how to use the sharps and the flats, and you'll learn all these other things. It's the same thing about like learning how to beatbox. Maybe there's noises you feel super comfortable with, but you can't do a certain snare. You can't contort your mouth in a way to play this, make this certain snare noise, right?
My beatboxing could use some improvement.
That's when like stuff like this, where you have to sit down, you have to study, you have to figure out what you have to do, and sometimes you need to take breaks. It's not even like sit down and like think about it and be like, man, I need to just keep trying this over and over. Sometimes you need to step back. You need to like go on YouTube and look up different techniques. You need to sit down and think about what you're good at, what you're bad at. Take notes on stuff, right? Having a notepad open when you play games is excellent. Just have a notepad open, write down things that...
I hadn't considered that.
You remember from the match, right? Oh man, you know what I really sucked at? I blocked this move and I didn't know what it was. I need to go check that after training mode. Write that down, right? How do you get better at making decisions? You got to keep playing so that you can build muscle memory, and you have to have moments over and over and over. When you block the move 100 times, you know how to punish it, right? When you block the move 10 times, you're like, is it minus this? Is it, what is it? I don't have the muscle memory drilled into my hands. It's the same thing with drilling combos in training mode. It's the same thing with practicing, playing the same chords over and over and over. It's the same thing with singing, doing vocal exercises to warm yourself up. Any of these things are like skill building exercises that you have to do. It's the same thing with commentary. It's the same thing with learning how to cook or riding a bike or any kind of skill that takes work. You're going to have to sit down and think about it and work on improving it, right? Like talking on camera. I was not good at talking on camera at first. I actually was very good at speaking into a microphone, but not used to talking on camera. And I had to practice talking on camera over and over and over until I became comfortable with it, like public speaking, right? Any techniques to expand your mental bandwidth? That's a tough one. Probably just takes trial and error, and yeah, that's one of those things you'd have to probably sit down and focus on. That's just another skill to build. That's just another thing that you'd have to look up and see what kind of techniques people have, right? And see like what their thought processes are. Try different things out, right? That's one thing that you have to remember, is that a lot of trial and error goes into self-improvement. And once you know the process about starting with nothing, building a set of skills, adding things in, removing bad habits or removing nasty things that you do, constantly building skills until you have something more than what you started with, until you feel comfortable with where you are, is the same process you do for everything. The same process for learning will never change, right? It will never change when, no matter what the skill is.
Yeah, a lot of the methodologies of getting better at something, you know, they'll apply to fighting games, but they'll also apply to any other skill you'd care to name. Practice, muscle memory, rote, and things of that nature.
You'll find different hardships and you'll have different starting levels about where you are, but you'll always be like that. You know what I mean? It'll always be like that, no matter what you want to learn, no matter what you're interested in learning. No matter what skill it is, whether it's in a video game or in real life, it's always like that, right? My future career will be self-improvement? Hell no. I do like teaching, though. I've done a lot of coaching and teaching before, so I find self-improvement is obviously an important part about that. Do I rewatch my commentary? All the time. There are words and saying.
Yeah, that's something I could do, but I don't really have the time to, is rewatching my streams, my VODs, and seeing as an observer if there's anything that sticks out to me that didn't stick out to me at the time in the moment when I was playing. You know, it's I think it's a lot easier to pick up on mistakes when you're not engaged in the mental preoccupation of actually playing out the game, you know. If you've ever watched like a Let's Play or something, you said, I could have done that easy. It's different when you're behind the controller, and I think people lose track of that when they are behind the controller. You know, they'll get frustrated instead of realizing, like, just taking a moment being like, oh, I made a mistake there. You know, they'll blame the controller, or they'll blame lag, or they'll blame the game, or they'll blame their opponent, or whatever. But that's usually not the case.
Things and phrases that you cycle through as a commentator that sometimes you do it too much, so you change to something else. But everybody has vocal habits that are hard to kick, and it just takes practice and repetition and planning to get rid of it. So, you know, it's just like that, sort of as a person. And everybody has default phrases that they go to when they don't know what to say. Your brain has to fill space. No matter how experienced you are with public speaking, your brain needs to fill space.
Okay, so he's talking about commentating right now. Which is another thing that I wouldn't mind doing, commentating. But I got to know my stuff first. Got to know my stuff.
Right. You know? Those are like the phrases that I use often. Your brain has to comprehend what you're saying and come up with what you're going to say next. So even if you're an excellent public speaker, there will be moments where you're like, I'm not quite sure what I'm going to say next. So let me make sure that I cover some time and then I'll get there. Yeah, learning how to curse or learning how to not to curse. That's like a switch. In my mind, I have a switch. You notice on my stream, I curse all the time. All the time. Except for when I started doing this portion.
Yeah, I try not to curse. I think a few slip out. But I'm very mindful of what I say. And there are sometimes, like, especially if you see my streams, there are times where I really pause before where I would curse. And I just try to let the emotion out without actually letting the word out.
Where I realized this would probably go up on YouTube, then I turned it off.
Yeah.
But in general, I have an on and off switch for cursing, right? When you're speaking to somebody that you need to impress, you should probably not do as much cursing. Or if you're going to be on stream, you should probably not curse as much. But, or around children. I curse a lot around children. I don't know why, but kids don't count to me for my switch. It's just something that you kind of have
to... It's nothing they haven't heard before.
...to deal with when you're on comm.
That doesn't make it okay, I'm just saying.
Because, you know, at Wednesday Night Fights I curse, but on CPT I don't curse. But anyway, self-improvement takes a lot of work. And learning a skill takes a lot of trial and error. But you can't be mad at yourself when you lose, and you can't be mad at yourself when you fail. It's more important that you recognize mistakes and work to improve them than not have any mistakes. Everybody makes mistakes. I'm probably going to rewatch that. Me talking about improvement, I'll probably rewatch this and be like, you know what? Here's how I should have phrased this instead, or here's the example I should have used off the cuff instead. And I will probably be like, I fucked that all up. But it happens, right? Like, you know, we're human beings. You can always be better at this. It's why I often tell stories and stuff on my stream and practice public speaking on here. It's the reason my stream is used for commentary. If you think about every other commentator that does commentary for fighting games, right? There is no way they have more practice than I do. Because I stream 3 or 4 days a week, and when I'm not streaming, I'm at events commentating live. So it's impossible for them to have...
So I'd be curious to know, is that a thing where there'll be a live event or somebody like playing a fighting game or playing an esport of some kind, and then there's a separate stream of somebody who's just commentating on it? I guess that's a thing you could do. You could practice commentary, whether or not anybody's watching you. In fact, it might be more comfortable if nobody's watching you, but then afterwards you'd have a VOD of just commentary unless you embed the stream you're commentating on, but then there's a delay. Anyway, that's outside the scope of this video, at least as far as I'm concerned.
More practice time for me, and because I have more practice time, it'll be easier for me to say what I want to say.
Okay, so towards the end there, Seijam got into more specifics of his own situation. But the meat of the video came at the start, where he actually reiterated some of the understandings that I already had, where sometimes playing to win is not the way you will improve yourself. If you can get the win, it doesn't necessarily mean you were challenged or that you tried something that was successful. It may mean you got lucky, or you mashed, or you or your opponent sneezed, or, you know, whatever. But if you place winning above improving, you'll get more sporadic wins, but you won't get the improvement. And you'll stagnate, you'll plateau, and you'll feel frustrated. So I think that's the main takeaway, is don't fall into that trap of, especially right out of the gate, like me, trying to win every fight you're in, trying to win every match. It's about putting tools in your toolbox. That's the MO that I'm trying for. I've had lots of moves where I just couldn't figure out how to counter the move or how to avoid damage from the move. Sometimes it feels like I'm blocking, or I tell it to block, but I'm not blocking the right way, or it's a low attack and I blocked mid or whatever. It takes a bit of stepping back and practicing, and also experimentation. And that's stuff that I don't know. I guess I would do that as homework. I don't know if I would stream all that, because I don't think it's very entertaining to watch somebody just try to work something out. I mean, it's entertaining to see them figure it out, but not the process that leads up to it, you know? So yeah, well, thank you, Sajam, for that video. Thank you for watching. If you want to watch me stream my fighting game journey, I'll be linking that in the description. I'll also be providing a link to Sajam's video in the description as well. And yeah, I'll see you next time. Okay, bye.